This Sunday marks the 70th anniversary of KTLA.
That's right. On January 22nd, 1947, Bob Hope introduced this station to Los Angeles. Eric Spillman takes a look back and honors three newsmen who dedicated their lives to KTLA.
Every day, nearly 100 people come together to produce KTLA's newscasts. From reporters to anchors, writers, producers, assignment desk editors, photographers, directors, stage crew, engineers, and graphic artists, it takes a village. As we celebrate KTLA's 70th anniversary, let's take a minute to honor three men whose contributions really stand above the rest. Their names? Stan Chambers, Larry McCormick, and Hal Fishman. These three newsmen dedicated their lives and careers to KTLA, and they made a monumental impact, not only on KTLA's success, but on the community and the news industry at large. KTLA had been on the air for just 11 months when Stan Chambers arrived.
The press secretary of Senator Kennedy says that his condition is very critical.
Stan Chambers was always there to report on the major stories, including the first live breaking news story on KTLA, the real-life drama of a young girl trapped in a well, the Bel Air fires, the night Senator Robert F. Kennedy was killed, the L.A. riots, and the Northridge earthquake.
He was coming through now, and there's a over the broken rubble.
Stan's career at KTLA spanned more than six decades. He covered more than 22,000 stories and touched countless lives. Anyone who was fortunate enough to cross paths with Stan would agree that his humanity and his infectious spirit inspired all of us to lead better lives.
The deadline for applicants to declare their candidacy for governor is just a week away.
Larry McCormick was one of the first African-American newscasters in the country. Early in his career, he hosted musical programs, radio talk shows, and he appeared in TV and in movies. During his 33 years at KTLA, he reported on everything from the weather to sports, health and fitness reports, to the news, as the weekend anchor on KTLA's News at 10 broadcast.
Awaiting the arrival of Shepherd One and Pope John Paul II.
Larry guided audiences through all the historic moments with grace and integrity. Larry devoted his life to his community, volunteering for so many nonprofit organizations.
There's a special place for Larry McCormick, not only here at KTLA, but in the entire broadcasting industry. Larry paved the way for future generations of aspiring African-American broadcasters.
Reward money for the Los Angeles Strangler will total $140,000.
In 1965, the owner of KTLA, Gene Autry, hired a man named Hal Fishman as a news anchor. At the time, Hal was an assistant professor of political science at Cal State LA.
As O.J. Simpson surrendered to police tonight,
Hal quickly became the face of KTLA. He reported on major stories like the Watts riots, the assassination of Robert F. Kennedy, the Sylmar and Northridge earthquakes, and the terrorist attacks on September 11th.
But there was one story that may have made the most impact.
The Los Angeles Police Department has launched an internal investigation.
The beating of Rodney King by LAPD officers. It was reported first by Hal Fishman. Hal was the anchor on KTLA's nighttime newscast and the show's managing editor for 32 years. Just before his death, he was presented with a certificate from the Guinness Book of World Records for serving as the world's longest-running television newscaster.
All of us at KTLA have learned so much from Stan, Larry, and Hal.
Their legacies are a daily reminder for each of us to approach our work with tenacity, dedication, and integrity. These three icons are role models, and without their contributions, KTLA would simply not be what it is today.
Stan, Larry, and Hal, we know you're watching, and on behalf of the entire KTLA family, thank you.
Well done, Eric. That's a great tribute.
It really, that was the first time that we got to see that, and that's really fantastic. And all of you, our viewers, who ask all the time about what it was like, you know, to work with these men, and really an honor.
It was an honor for both of us.
Yeah. KTLA's 70th anniversary, a year-long celebration. We have lots of special features and giveaways, including this limited edition anniversary mug, and you could be among the very first to have it.
70 KTLA viewers will be selected to each win a pair of KTLA's 70th anniversary mugs. To enter, go to ktla.com/70.